could have named a lineup that seems to suggest that they will attack from the onset. Mm-hmm. With Betim United consistently looking to be suspect almost all the times and leaking goals, what do you think could result from the possible incessant pressure as Ante Kotoko might launch in the opening 15 minutes, or how the 15 minutes of the first half will play out?
Well, what it could do, and I think that is a more likely scenario, is the fact that Bechem United are going to break up, because for the better part of this season, you've seen them quite strong in the first half and then capitulate and break up in the second half, where they lose concentration. But against teams with very, very strong setups in all departments, they break fairly quickly. However, on a few occasions where their midfield, and especially Peter Essien, has had his way. We did one game in Bechem where Bechem United played mighty Jets, and we saw the way that they were able to play, and they were able to launch consistent pressure on mighty Jets. I mean, mighty Jets is not in the same form that Kumasi Asante Kotoko are in. However, I think that if Bechem United are able to keep things simple and keep things simple, they could give Kotoko a good run for their money. But I'm sure they know that they are going to have a lot of work to do, especially with the kinds of players Kotoko have paraded.
Well, Asante Kotoko have not conceded too many goals in this year's Premier League, but sometimes they've looked really vulnerable. Not the same backline playing today, but against Amedaos, Asante Kotoko showed signs of being vulnerable there. The last time they played here, that is Bechem United and Kotoko conceded two goals against this team before eventually winning by 3-2. Adai, Peter Essien, which could be the areas these two players could be outlets where Bechem could get goals? How would Asante Kotoko map up to close shop?
Well, Kotoko have the on the left wing, and at left back, first of all, Abdul Rahman, who has been impressive this season. A lot of talk has been done about this young man. I think that on occasions when he has overlapped, you know, he has been able to deal with the threats because he's young and exuberant, so he's able to go forward and is able to clamp down on that threat that Peter Essien may have on that side of the field. On the other hand, I think that Yao Champong has been solid enough. Yao Frimpong has been solid enough. Even in the mold of, you know, being called into the senior national team, I think that he will be able to do the job against Peter Essien. Peter Essien has something that Yao Frimpong and Abdul Rahman both don't have, and that is experience. How they are going to be able to deal with it is going to be key. But for the other players such as Theophilos Apor as well, I think that those guys are experienced enough. And personally, I'm fascinated by what the prospects are going to be in midfield in this game.
Well, I'm fascinated equally. By this time, it will be the turn of Prince Anan to take us through the first 45 minutes of this game between Bechem United, who are looking for their points, and Kumasi Asante Kotoko pushing to come back to winning ways.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the Babayaro Sports Stadium, where this afternoon we're bringing you match in the Ghana Globe Premier League. We're whittling it down to the final stages with just about three matches to go. And this afternoon is week 28 of action, and we're seeing Kumasi Asante Kotoko taking on Bechem United in a home game for the Porcupine Warriors, an away game for Bechem United. Bechem United started the competition this season with their home ground here at the Babayaro Sports Stadium, but of course managed to put their own park, the Nana Fosu Jiabos Park, in shape. And so they had to move out of the Babayaro Sports Stadium. And officials taking the pleasantries from the two sets of sides. Kumasi Asante Kotoko sporting the traditional all red outfit, and Bechem United this afternoon are sporting their lemon green colors. My name is Prince Anan, and I'm bringing you commentary from the Kumasi Sports Stadium, or the Babayaro Sports Stadium as it's known and called. And taking a look at the Kotoko lineup, the regular suspects are in place. Ahmed Toure, Daniel Nieje, Michael Anaba, Yeboah Afrani is a new face in there. Awal Mohammed comes back into the central defensive position. Ohene Brenya as well. Gideon Bayan and Yao Frimpong are all starting, with Isaac Amwako being in goal for Kumasi Asante Kotoko. And for Bechem United, they are occupying the last but one spot on the league table. It's imperative that they win today, but can they against the uncrowned league champions. Maxwell Fifi-Eshan is in goal. But Maxwell Mensah, I should say, comes in with experience in central defense. He's going to be supported by James Papayao. Theophilus Apo, formerly of Accra Asafo, comes in with a lot of grit. And Peter Asien, Richard Adai are the two players to look out for in terms of goal-scoring abilities. Don't forget, Abraham Annan can also get in a goal or two when the going gets tough. And so, basically, it's a match of equals. And officials for this afternoon are just about ready for action. Sylvester Ajogu, class one referee from Takoradi, and will be supported on lines one and lines two by Ruben Lai and Isaac Egan. All coming from the Western region, and that man, Maxwell Konedu, will have to bounce back to winning ways after he was bundled out of the MTN FA Cup by no less a team than Amidaios Professionals. Fourth official, Joe Baffo. And the captain for the visitors, Bechem United, this afternoon, the honours falls on James Papayao, sporting the number 14 jersey. The formation in the jersey 4-4-2. Once again, my name is Prince Anan, and you're welcome to the live coverage of the Ghana Globe Premier League Week 28. And it's Kumasi Asante Kotoko taking on Bechem United. I'll soon be joined in commentary position by Albert Abebio. And former Black Star International, Dan Owusu, is in charge of Bechem United. Of course, the two players are former Black Star Internationals. Dan Owusu of the older generation, Maxwell Konedu of the younger. Fans are not here in their numbers. And of course, Kumasi Asante Kotoko fans know that it's already a done deal. They are the uncrowned league champions. But Bechem United, occupying a precarious position on the league lock, would need the maximum points if they are to salvage their continued participation in the league this season. And away the referee's whistle goes for the commencement of the match. Kumasi Asante Kotoko playing from left to right. And on the near side is Yao Frimpo. But of course, last two matches ended in draws. One against Bikum Arsenal here, the other against Bando Heart of Lions away. Daniel Ania J, the kingpin in midfield. He's not got his partner, Michael Ekufu, in the squad today. But Yeboah Afrani can take that role and take that perfectly. Indications that Kumasi Asante Kotoko would love to announce their presence. Ahmed Toure and ball has been bundled off him. But an opportunity for Kumasi Asante Kotoko. First offside on the far side. Let's take a look at the replay. Ahmed Toure, ball was taken away from him. And Daniel Nieje was there to recover ably. Michael Anaba would be the gentleman to partner Daniel Nieje. And Yeboah Afrani, of course, Yeboah Afrani, more of a defensive midfielder. Free kick advantage to Bechem United as Maxwell Fifi-Eshan. Ball headed on. And again, it's Yeboah Afrani this time. Kumasi Asante Kotoko keeping tabs on their opponents. Michael Anaba sends a pass through there. Chance for goal number one. Good reflex save by Maxwell Fifi-Eshan. Referee noticed the infringement. And Ahmed Toure will agree with the referee. Sylvester Ajogu right on top of affairs. And Albert, first incursion for the Porcupine Warriors.
Showing the signs that they want to get an early goal over here. And I think that once or twice they've used the outlet on the left. Well, Gerson Okra is going to operate from to attempt to break down Bechem United. We mentioned that the opening 15 minutes were going to be key because Asante Kotoko, with the lineup that they have named, we're going to look for the goals here. And with the vulnerability throughout the course of the season Bechem United have shown, I thought they were going to struggle. And those signs have been there, but too early to say that Kotoko will have their day here.
And we take a look at the replay again. It's a free kick advantage to the Porcupine Warriors. They already have the league wrapped up here in Ghana. And Kumasi Asante Kotoko will be bouncing back to Africa after a couple of years' absence. Free kick advantage to Bechem United. And Rashid Abdul has got a very good culture left foot. Yabu Afrani, Michael Anna, but Daniel Nyeje all in the wall. Pass is laid on as a right-footed drive dealt with by Isaac Amuako. No problems at all for Kotoko from this free kick.
Well, but the wall broke up too quickly. Isaac Amuako had his body behind the shot. Ground up on target though, but not too difficult of a shot to beat Isaac Amuako. Despite the fact that Asante Kotoko might have started a game so well or in a very good fashion, Bethel United themselves aren't one of those sides that are afraid to take on their opponent. We've seen them do so here.
Yao Frimpong starting an attack for Kumasi Asante Kotoko. And the Spurs crowd that are here, of course, speaks volumes of the fact that fans of Kumasi Asante Kotoko know that it's already a done deal, but it's Ahmed Toure in the 18-yard box, heavily policed by Abdul Rashid. Toure again brings the ball back. Michael Anaba was down in the 18-yard box. He's up. Henry Ohenibrenya has the ball. And Yabu Afrani takes his eye off the ball. It's picked up by Bechem. And Richard Adai, the goal machine of Bechem United, goes down. Free kick advantage to the visitors.
Well, on that occasion, Richard Adai took too many seconds on the ball, dwelled too much on the ball. When he plays in the position he's playing, that is protecting the back four, he needs to do it quick and simple. Once you get players closing down on your opponents, closing down on you, it will be difficult for you to keep your ball. Richard Adai is one of such players who keeps working hard throughout the course of 90 minutes, and he would want to take chances like that.
Long throw by Rashid Abdul, chance for Bethel United, a drive on target, and it's goal number one! Easy goal scored by Reginald Asante. And he's a gentleman I've not seen in a very long while after his surgeon with Liberty Professionals. And of course, going outside the shores of this country. He is known as Reggie. And Reginald gets Bechem up by 1-0.
It would affect the tunes Kumasi Asante Kotoko will be singing here, especially once they've gone down by 1-0. I mentioned that Asante Kotoko have shown some vulnerability in the last three games that they've played, one in the FA Cup and then two in the Premier League. Not considered in the Premier League for a long time, but that was some poor defending there. Nobody being spot on from the Asante Kotoko end to be quicker to pick the second ball. And I think that Reginald did so well to take his chance and get Bethel United into the lead.
5 minutes gone in this match, and it's Bethel United who are up by 1-0. And it's a free kick advantage to the visitors as they look for goal number two. It was a long throw in from Abdul Rashid, headed down by Awal Mohamed. He went down and Reggie lashed onto it. Goal number one for Bethel United. They're looking good so far.
If you look at the goal once again, you will struggle to pardon the Asante Kotoko back line. A routine throw in for them to deal with. And if you look at the personnel in the back line, particularly in central defense, Awal Mohamed and Ohenibrenya, those should be balls they should fairly deal with very well. And they didn't do too much to do that. Awal Mohamed went up there. His timing of that particular aerial situation was poor. It landed. Reginald was quicker to the ball. Credit to him to have read it so well and taken the goal.
Temporary hold up is going to be a throwing advantage to Kumasi Asante Kotoko. And let's see how they respond to this early goal by Bethel United. Yao Frimpong spreads play to the far side, running after that. It's Augustin Okra. Augustin gets the ball, he waits for the support, and it comes in. Gideon Bar lays on a pass towards the 18-yard box. Good opportunities coming the way of Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Holding on to the ball and then crossing into the 18-yard box. Anaba is up there for it. Can't get to the ball. Cleared away by Bethel United. A trip from behind. Richard Adai goes on. Referee says game should continue. Awal Mohamed. Awal wasn't in charge of central defensive duties when Kotoko played against Abidal's Professionals in the MTN FA Cup. A lot of fans believe that if he had been there, it would have been a different story.
Well, looking at the goal conceded by Asante Kotoko, probably they will rewrite their notes or their assessment or probably even their analysis. Because in that game against Amidals, the central defenders on that occasion, Osei Kofi and then John Kufuor,
on some occasions look really poor in their judgment of situations. And over there, if you look at the timing of the attempted header clearance, it was poor from Awad Mohamed, but it's too early. Teams take time to some of the occasions, settle into games. Probably it's one of such occasions, but he was poor together with his entire defense to have considered that first goal.
Chance coming the way of Kumasi Asante Kotoko on that occasion. It was only Ahmed Touré in the 18-yard box. And so it's going to be a slow build-up by Bechem United. Bechem United have won 5 matches, lost 11, and drawn 11 this season. Occupy the last but one spot on the league table. Very precarious position, if you ask me. Out of 27 matches, they only have 26 points. And so they will do well to get themselves some 3 points in this afternoon's game. But it's a chance by Kumasi Asante Kotoko, the shot from the uncultured left foot of, or the unfavored left foot of Ahmed Touré, dealt with by Maxwell Mensah. And Ohene Brenya will guide the ball all the way to Isaac Amwako. Good recovery by Rashid Abdul. To the far side finds the skipper James Papayao. Pushed on the far side by Evans. Osei. Ball comes back to Evans. And Bechem United is a slow and a cautious build up. Offside, quite obvious. And it'll be interesting to see the partnership between Reginald and Richard Adai, who's been getting most of the goals for Bechem United this season. This is probably the first goal registered by Reginald this season for Bechem United. But for Richard Adai, he's on 10 goals so far for Bechem United. Let's see how that partnership goes.
Well, this afternoon we've seen Richard Adai work so hard on some occasions, put pressure on Jeboa, Franny Jeboa, and then even the back line. What it does is that Reginald can play off his shoulder and pick those scrums or feed on scrums and get goals here. We've seen him out of virtually nothing score a goal here. For Adai also, he is able to take his chances some of the times. Rescued Bechem United in some of the games they played. One of said games was the game against them. He is able to pounce on balls you feel should not cause any havoc in the goal area and he scores. So those two players could be potentially the biggest threat to Asante Kotoko this afternoon. We've already seen Reginald score one.
Kotoko reeling in defense, dealt with by Awal Mohamed and Isaac Amwako. And Bechem United, really, they have been buoyed up by that early goal scored by Reginald Asante. Augustine on the far side for Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Another comes in to help. Gideon Bias also there to lend support. Daniel Adni Ejay works the 1-2 with Yeboah Franny into the 18-yard box. Chance for the Porcupine Warriors. Goalkeeper comes out to the rescue for Bechem United.
Some of the times, it's not been a question of Asante Kotoko not probing or not looking for the goals or playing lackadaisically. It's been a question of not utilizing their opportunities. We've seen once where Augustine Okra crossed in the 3rd minute and Ahmed Touré was unable to score. And a while ago, another opportunity missed.
Kumasi Asante Kotoko come forward through Michael Anaba. Augustine says in the cross, and that's the face-saving equalizing goal by Ahmed Touré. Obviously, well worked out plan by Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Augustine Okra got the ball all right. Sent in the cross. Ahmed Touré was in the right place at the right time.
That will be a huge relief for Asante Kotoko, getting Ahmed Touré one to score and then getting the equalizer here. And Anaba did so well, passing the ball onto the part of Augustine Okra, who didn't waste any time, giving Ahmed Touré the easiest of task of getting the goal for Asante Kotoko, virtually kneeing the ball or using the tie to score on that occasion. Very good goal scored by them. But then we mentioned the fact that if Asante Kotoko were going to score, one of the major outlets would be down the left side where Augustine Okra operated. He didn't get Ahmed Touré scoring from the 3rd minute, but on this occasion, it was always going to be difficult for Ahmed Touré to miss. Very good goal scored by Kotoko.
And a cross-section of the VIP stands. Ahmed Touré, the goal scorer for Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Dr. KK Sapo, Mr. Wilberforce in full. They're all in the VIP box. Watching their team, the Porcupine Warriors. It's Yao Frimpong. Another opportunity for goal number two. The cross comes in. Maxwell Mensah was in the right place at the right time. Safety first. It's a corner kick to Kumasi Asante Kotoko.
Well, keep it simple at the back. That should be the message from Dan Owusu. And Maxwell Mensah did it on that occasion. But Betin looked really stretched whenever Kumasi Asante Kotoko bumped down the flanks, especially on the left. But on the right, we've not seen Yao Frimpong make those dazzling runs down the right. But for the first time he did it, they looked really straight on some. Maxwell came across to kick the ball for a corner kick.
Okra with the corner kick is headed out by Papaya. Richard Adai and Cole, let's see what they can do out of this. It's a counter attack for Bechem United. Ball comes to Riggy. Ball has been taken off Riggy by Awal Mohamed. He brings him down. Kick from behind. And Riggy, very apologetic, apologizes for that. And that was a challenge earlier on. A little kick in the back of Awal Mohamed. This is Michael Anaba. Daniel Nieje has Yao Frimpong waiting. Picks up Augustin Okra. He's moved from the left to the right. Daniel Nieje twisting and turning. Yeboa Afrani tries to play the 1-2 with Michael Anaba. It's cleared out by Papayao James. Only as far as Gideon Ba. Good turn in midfield. Yao Frimpong plays the 1-2 with Okra and gets it back. Yao Frimpong goes round Maxwell Mensah, sends in the cross. Too long. Gideon Ba, let's see if he can get the ball back into the 18-yard box. Another strong one to Yao Frimpong. Pulls the ball down. Looking for the shot from behind. Augustin Okra. Ball back to Okra. Kotoko holding on to the ball. Yeboa Afrani. Cross comes in. Aimed towards Ahmed Touré. Well worked out by Bichin United. Reginald Asante. Asante gets the ball again. Looks for the support. Asante still on the ball, lays on the pass. It's an opportunity for Bechem United. Richard Adai gets into the 18-yard box, lays on the pass. Reginald sends in the drive across the face of goal. Another sweet builder by Bechem United, but obviously missing that final touch.
Exactly, and I think that Asante Kotoko have been left off the hook. Yes, they've been working hard at Bechem United to get into that position, but it was too easy. First, Ohini Brenyam mistiming the bounce of that ball. But then he went to Reginald. They allowed him to bring the ball onto his left foot. You look at it, not too much pressure mounted on him from Ohini Brenya. And then when Gideon Ba came in, it was too late.
Long enterprising shot at goal by Bechem United, coming off the boot of Abraham Anand. Maxwell Konedo will issue instructions from the touchlines. And Albert, just before the game, you had a tete-a-tete with Maxwell Konedu. What do you get from the kind of discussion you had with him? Is he looking for the 3 points? Is he looking for a draw? Before you bring your answers, this is Kumasi Asante Kotoko coming up with an incursion. Gideon Bam with the cross, dealt with by Maxwell Fifi-Eshan, the goalkeeper, and cleared out by Bechem United. There's pressure on them. Yeboa Afrani spreads play to the near side. It's Yao Frimpong. Daniel Nieje has timed his run. Lays on the pass to Ahmed Touré. Daniel Nieje and he's offside. Meanwhile, goalkeeper Maxwell Fifi-Eshan again coming out with a quick, reflexive move. But back to what I was trying to find out from you as we take a look at the replay again. What do you get from Maxwell Konedu?
Well, the information to his charges or from the discussions I had with him, they are not going to harm him.
And that is a thunderbolt of a goal! Augustin Okra out of nothing into the third of Bechem United. He let one go from his right and his left foot. He hits the upright, dropped deep into the net. Maxwell Fifi-Eshan this time was beaten to it. Kumasi Asante Kotoko have shot themselves up by 2-1.
The cross came from Gideon Bass. Take a look at the replay. Maxwell dealt with it on that first time of asking. Headed out by Maxwell Mensah. And cleared away. And Kumasi Asante Kotoko are up by 2-1. As we take a look at that drive again. Solid, perfect goal. Look at the goalkeeper. He was standing in Wonderland.
Well, he looked bemused, rightly so. I think that he will rival any of the fans in the stands because he couldn't do anything about it as a goalkeeper. He could only watch and admire. And that admiration or that particular goal sums up probably what I was going to say, that Asante Kotoko came out for this game looking for the 3 maximum points. And from the discussions I had with Maxwell Kunedu, he felt that the analysis of Asante Kotoko's results in the past 2 league matches have not been right. People wrongly judging them to playing it soft against opponents, and that he was coming out here to show to every other person that they were looking for the 3 maximum points. In those games they've played, it's not gone their way. The attitude of the players some of the times has not been top notch, they've been complacent, but they were looking for the 3 maximum points here. Save that particular early goal they considered, I think that over the course of 19 minutes, Asante Kotoko have shown no mercy. They have been really professional, looking for the 3 maximum points. And for Augustino Kraft, his first few matches for Asante Kotoko this season didn't go too well for him. But he's come out here a different player altogether. He's reminded me of the player I saw at Red Bull Academy, where he thrived on having a free role rather than being restricted to the left side of any attack or any team's attack. And over here, he's profited from that. He's made one goal from the left, and then from deep midfield, he scored a very good goal.
Daniel Nyeje in midfield for Kotoko. Yepua Afrani. Michael Amaba falls deep. And Kumasi Asante Kotoko firmly in the driving seat. Daniel Nyeje searching ball. It was a very long one aimed at Richard Yeboah. Throwing that back to him. Dan Owusu not too happy with his charges. Issuing out strong instructions.
And then again, Asante Kotoko are not missing they are not missing Michael Akufu that much. We've seen Afrani Yeboah play a disciplined game this afternoon, and he's combined beautifully with Anaba and Nyeje. That pass didn't go too well for Nyeje, but Asante Kotoko are pressing well, keeping the ball well, and giving Bekche United all sorts of problems. And from what we've seen of Bekche United in 20 minutes, it sums up their season so far. Looking for points, but some of the times their body language or their general organization on their field of play not helping their intentions.
Kumasi Asante Kotoko 2, Bekche United 1. If you've just joined us, we're bringing you action in the Ghana Globe Premier League. It's brought to you by the kind courtesy of the Rice Masters. Taste to share and moments to remember. And ably supported by Glow, rule your world. Azar Paints, number 1. Calibu, air dead, papa. Fruitily full of natural goodness. Azar Paints, number 1. Yafripong, Michael Anaba. And good ball control by Kumasi Asante Kotoko. They keep the ball to themselves. They're trying to tease Bekche United out of their own zone into the midfield, get them committed, and then float the long balls into the 18-yard box. They've done so a couple of times. Out of that, you've seen one goal scored by Augustine Okra. I don't know whether Bekche United, in your opinion, have been able to identify the strategy of Kumasi Asante Kotoko, and if they have any means to thwart that effort.
Well, they are keeping a lot of bodies behind the ball, Bekche United, and it's clearly an identification of the threat Kumasi Asante Kotoko presents.